The sustainable investing movement has grown exponentially over the past couple of decades. It now accounts for about $35 trillion invested in equities, as well as about $4 trillion in green debt markets. This is forecasted to grow to about one-third of all assets under management by 2025. Sustainable investors, for the most part, they employ a very standard investment strategy. They invest in firms that are considered to be green, so firms that have very low carbon emissions that are good for the environment. And they exclude firms that are brown, so firms that have negative impact on the environment. The thought process behind this is that by rewarding green firms and lowering their cost of financing, that allows green firms to do more of what they do, which is good for the environment. And further, by punishing brown firms, by basically making it more expensive for them to access capital, that this will somehow also incentivize brown firms to become more green. What we find in the data is that if you lower the cost of financing for firms that are already green, they don't become meaningfully more green. And in some ways, this is not very surprising because most green firms in the US economy, they're in the industries of insurance, finance, and healthcare. So they start out with almost no environmental impact by the nature of their business. And if they get cheaper access to capital, it's not as though they can further improve their environmental impact. They've effectively maxed out. Next, we look at what happens to firms that are brown when they are punished, so when they have more expensive access to financing. What we find is that they tend to become more short-termist. They actually shy away from transitioning toward green production because to convert to green production is actually quite expensive for these firms. It requires that they borrow right now, which has become more expensive, in order to invest in the project that could pay off far in the future. So when these brown firms are punished by sustainable investors, they're slightly closer to financial distress, slightly closer to bankruptcy. And the way that firms typically react to financial distress is they double down on existing production methods, okay? Because that's a way to avoid costs right now. It's a way to generate cash flow right now. So what we find is then that raising the cost of capital for brown firms actually causes them to emit more greenhouse gases per unit of production.